Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a paper cut galaxy look in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, let's start a new document. So we'll come over here to create new. I'm going to go with web because we're going to use RGB colors, which make for a really vibrant look. So let's just choose minimum right here, and then we'll come down here to create. I'm going to hit M to get to my rectangle tool, and I'm just going to make a little thin bar right up here. And now I'm going to hit the gradient slider to give it a white to black gradient fill. I'll get on my outline and just click none. And now I'm going to change my gradient by double clicking the white here, and we'll choose blue. And then I'm going to choose a really light color of blue. So maybe this one. Yeah, maybe we'll make this a little darker. We can double click our color and just choose a darker blue. We'll say okay. Okay, I'm really liking the way this looks. Now I'm going to come up here to object rasterize, and we'll make this RGB and 300 ppi and say okay. And then we'll do an image trace. And the reason I like to do this is because it separates it into colors that I can choose that are solids. So let's do 16 colors. And as you can see, it's divided those up. Let's expand with Command E. And we'll say okay. Okay, now we have a lot of different colors to choose from. Okay, so now I'm going to draw the background of our scene. I'll hit M on my keyboard to get the rectangle tool again. And I'll just draw a big rectangle in the middle of my screen. I'm going to hit I to get my eyedropper, and I'm going to make it this darkest color right over here on the left. Okay. So this will just be the background. Now I'm going to hit Command C and then Command F, which is paste in front. That's Control C and Control F. So we made a copy that's right on top of this. I'm going to hit N on my keyboard. I'm going to start drawing right along this path here, and then I'm going to veer off and come over here like this. And we'll end up going down along that same path. Now what you're doing is redrawing that shape. I'm going to hit I on my keyboard and choose the lightest color that I have. So we basically redrew this shape into this shape. So we still have the bottom corners left from the original shape, if that makes sense. Okay, so let's copy this, and I'm going to paste behind with Command B or Control B on a PC. And then I'm going to hit V on my keyboard and just pull this up like this. And I'll hit I to get the next color. We'll do a mid-tone here. Okay, now whenever I do this, I want to change this up a little bit. So we can use our N tool, the pencil tool, to just redraw that shape a little bit. We'll come over here, maybe just do this. And we can smooth this out by hitting N and then holding Option on our keyboard. Just kind of go over those lines a little bit to get a smoother version. All right, and then we'll do it again. Copy, paste behind, and then grab this and pull it up. I'll hit I on my keyboard to get to my eyedropper, and then choose a little bit darker color. Then I'm going to redraw this to look like this. When you're redrawing, you have to start on a path and then end up on the same path. Now we'll hold Option to smooth this out a little bit. Now I think I'd like a cutout right here. So I'm going to hit P on my keyboard and then just draw a cutout in. Click and drag to kind of get the same angle as this. Click this one and then just kind of follow that up like that. All right. Now let's change that to something else so we can see what's going on. I'm going to select this with my selection tool and then hold shift and select this one also and just do a minus front down here in the Pathfinder. By the way, if you don't have any of these palettes open, you can come up here to Window and find them all here. Okay, so we'll do minus front. Okay, and now since it moved everything to the front, I'm going to Command X. We'll click back on this one and then Command B to put it right behind there. So that would be Control X, click on the one you want to paste it behind, and then Control B on your keyboard. Okay, I'm going to click this one and then copy. Then I'll click this one and paste behind. and then I'll drag it up. The reason I did that is because I don't want to cut out in this version. So let's go ahead and redraw this up like this. I'll hold Option or Alt on my keyboard to smooth that out. Maybe I'll get right on this with my direct selection tool and kind of just manipulate it that way. And I'm going to hit I on my keyboard and choose an even darker color. Now we're going to do the same thing on the top. So I'm going to copy this, paste in front, hit N on my keyboard, and then just come along like this. And then go back down that same path. I'll hit I and get this same color. I'm going to copy, paste behind, and then just drag this up a little bit. Hit I and select this color. Copy, paste behind. Pull this one down a little bit. Hit I and grab that color. And then one more time, I'll copy and paste behind and drag this one down a little bit and hit I to get this color. Now this one, I think I'm going to redraw a little bit so it's a little bit taller here. And we'll end up on that same line. Okay, that's looking good. I think I might just make this a little bit longer like this. And maybe we'll make these two a little shorter. There we go. Now to get the paper cutout look, we'll need to select everything except the background. I'm holding Shift to deselect that. Then we'll come down here and divide. And what this does, it makes each piece separate. Now I'm going to use my group selection tool to select these and hide them with Command 3 or Control 3. And I'll select these extra pieces that were going over the edge and delete those. And then I'll come back up here to Object, Show All. I'm going to use my group selection tool and select these down here. I'll hold Shift and deselect the background. And now we'll come up here to Effect, Stylize, and Drop Shadow. Let's do Preview and see what this looks like. Okay, I'm thinking it looks pretty good, but I think we want to do a -7 and a -7 here. And I think we want to put this up. Oh, that's looking nice. Let's put it at 30 and see what happens. Okay, that's really well defined, so we'll say okay. Then we'll grab these with our group selection tool. I'm going to deselect the background. And I'm also going to do the same thing, but we'll have the shadow going the other way. So we'll go to Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow, and then we'll have these be positive. We'll say okay. So that's how you get your paper cut. Let's go and get some little objects to put inside this paper cut. So I'm going to go out here to vecteezy.com, and I'm going to search for planets. Now, when you use designs on Vecteezy, you have to be careful because you'll need to read the license. If you're just using it for practice, it's no big deal, but if you want to use it commercially, you need to read about what's allowed and what's not. Okay, so I found this solar system one. Let's just download this. Let's come down here to this little caret and we'll show in Finder. Now, here it is. It's a zip file, and on a Mac, all you have to do is double click a zip. On a PC, you'll want to right-click and choose Extract. Okay, and here's a JPEG and an EPS. We'll grab that EPS and we'll pull it onto our Illustrator icon. Now here are all the planets. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. I'm going to use my group selection tool and just drag it across these right here. And then I'll hit Command X to cut. That's Control X on a PC. I'll select all with Command A or Control A. Delete it, and then paste in front. Okay, so that's got all the planets plus a little extra. Now I'm going to use my group selection to click once and click again on the selected area to select all the word and delete. I'll do the same down here. Oops, not the E though. I'll just delete all the words. I don't need those. Okay, so now I'm left with just the planets. I'm going to delete the black boxes. And now I'll select all of these and just copy them. And I'm going to Command tilde over to my design and paste them in. And now I'll get on a corner and just resize these a lot bigger. Now let's see how these are built. Okay, they are all grouped quite nicely, so we don't need to ungroup or anything like that. Now I want this Saturn image to be kind of right up in here, but underneath some of these and on top of some of them. First, I'm going to position it where I want, which is right about here. Then I'm going to Control X on a PC. And then I want it to be above this layer. So I'm going to click it and then Command F, which is paste in front. And as you can see, it's kind of hidden it between those two layers. I think that's pretty cool. Now I'm going to grab the red planet. I'll move it maybe right down into here. I'm going to Command X. Then I want it to be behind this one. And I'll Command B, which is paste behind, Control B on a PC. And now it's put it in that little area between those two layers. I'll grab the Earth. I'll move that one where I want it, maybe right up here. Maybe right here. Okay. Command X. I think I'll put it behind this one. So Command B. And it's hidden it in between there. I'm going to move this one up. Command X and then select this piece. And then Command B to put it behind there. And I'll treat the others in the same way. I don't need all of them within the layers, so that one will work right there. And now I'm gonna get the star tool and maybe make a few little stars in here, just real small. I'll hit D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black outline. Then I'll hit X and backslash to clear out the stroke. So we can kind of see those here. I'll just option drag them to create copies. And I think I might want these yellow. Yeah. We can make some little white dots that can be the more far away stars. I'm just option and dragging each piece. And now since we have kind of a drop shadow from some of these other pieces, let's hit G on our keyboard and click on that background. We'll make a copy. We'll deselect with Shift Command A, that's Shift Control A on a PC, and then paste in front. That'll put it right over the top of everything. And now I'm going to use this as a mask. That way it'll get rid of those drop shadows that you can see outside. I'm going to get my fill in front and then just clear it out. I'll select everything here and then just hit Command 7 or Control 7 on a PC. And now we have a clean edge. We don't have those drop shadows falling outside the frame. Now another thing you might want to do is add drop shadows on your planets. If you wanted to, that would be an interesting effect too. Okay, and that's it. That's how easy it can be to make kind of a layered look in your designs. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more like it, just hit the subscribe button and then the little bell to be notified every time a new video comes out, which is every Thursday. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.